and squad, many with their favorites, hoping to hear their names, many wondering how many changes you'll make. Let me hand it over to you to take us through your squad.
Okay, thank you. So first, I start with the keepers. Ronan Williams, Veli Modva, and Bruce Vuma. Defenders, Sidney Mobi, and Jabulo Blom, Sianda Xulu, Rashin Derak, and Jabulo Nkokobo, Terence Machego, Sefisio Glanti, and Tibang Pete. So midfielders, Spehele Sitole, Tabani Zuke, Ethan Brooks, Teboho Mokoena, Yusuf Maart, Mduduzi Mdansane, Keegan Dolly, Fagri Laquet, Evidence Magopa as strikers, Victor Letsualo, Percy Tau, Bongokule Longwane, and Modi Pule.
Well, there you have it. 24 men announced by the coach. Coach, say anything you want to say about your selection, your criteria you used before we do, of course, show the squad again and go through
it. It's a little bit different than before because I have 24 players. But it's because Victor Letsualo is suspended for the first game. But I wanted that he stay with us because I will maybe need him for the second game. So, and therefore I announced 24 players.
So, Pomozo, you see it, there it is on your screen. The goalkeepers, Ronan Williams, Veli Motwa, Bruce Vuma. You've also got, of course, as far as the defenders are concerned, Sidney Mobi is in there from Sekhukhune, Jabulo Blom of Kaizer Chiefs, Sianda Xulu, who plays in Tel Aviv, Rashid Deruk from Sundowns, Jabulo Ngobo of Kaizer Chiefs, Terence Mashego from Cape Town City, Sifiso Hlanti of Kaizer Chiefs, and Tibang Pete of Belenenses. Let's move now to the midfielders as you see them. It's Sphelele Sithole of Belenenses, it's Thabani Zuke with Golden Arrows, Ethan Brooks, TS Galaxy, Teboho Mokoena of SuperSport United, Yusuf Maart, Sekhukhune, Mduduzi Mdantsane of Cape Town City, and Keegan Dolly from Kaizer Chiefs. Your strikers, Fakhri Laké, Cape Town City, Evidence Magopa from Baroka, Victor Letsualo of Royal AM, a return for Percy Tau of Al Ahly, Bongokuhle Hlongwane of Maritzburg, and Modi Pule from Golden Arrows. This is your 24-man Bafana Bafana team for the next two games on the 11th and 14th of November. Hashtag Asibuyele Muva, SABC Sports, supporting Bafana. Forward we go. Whew, coach, I can imagine the difficulties of you having chosen the squad. Before we go into it, coach, I mean, we've seen you in the live games whenever televisions are there. We've seen you watch the games. Your journey to choosing the squad, the games that you've had to go watch, if you can just shine a little bit of light as to how you came to the squad, the games you watched, and the laborious toil of getting there.
Yes, as you know, when I came here, I didn't know one player way of speaking of South Africa, so I do know them, and I saw a lot of games. And after my first selection, I went on and you saw other players, and still now I see other players, and maybe therefore there are some new ones in the squad, like Fahri Laké, for example, Modi Pule, those are players I saw several times. And I think they can have a chance to be with us, and maybe wants to be in the squad. I will see what I will select for the game against Zimbabwe. But those players have the qualities. They are young players, so it's something what I said already for 3 months. Mm-hmm. This is very important for me, that we look for young players with quality. Mm-hmm. And I think when you see the selection again with the new players, certainly like Keegan Dolly, for example, who was several months. I didn't know where he was, but they did a great job. I read something about his coach Baxter, so he worked a lot. Yeah. And you see it on the pitch. Mm. You see, Dolly is again, Dolly, we know him. He's decisive also, he scores. So players like that, I like.
And coach, you've got a lot of local players, of course, from, you know, having watched the games here. How are you keeping an eye on the international conglomerate of players?
Yeah, there's something called Wisecard. Mm-hmm. So every Monday and Tuesday, you can see the games of the players, of the clubs where the players are playing in. So, and we do that. So I didn't have the occasion till now to go live, see them. What I will do in the next months now. But it's a very good thing. Monday or Tuesday, okay, we are in front of our computer and we see the game. And we see Sitolo, we see Pete, we see Piri, we see all those guys who are in Europe. And it's good because when you have to do every time to go and have to do the trip to Europe, it's too much time. You spend too much time. Now it's very good, but I will go to see them live also in the next months.
Right, let's go straight into it. I've got the two gentlemen here as we go through the squad, of course, with understanding and a little bit of more detail into that. You're going to see your graphic up in just a bit so you can see whoever it is that we're speaking about, starting with the goalkeepers, Ronwen Williams, Veli Mota, and Bruce Vuma. I think, you know, the last time we sat, Coach, you didn't mince your words on your belief in your number one and captain, Ronwen Williams. Veli Mota still there, and of course, Bruce Vuma as well.
When you're looking at the squad, Andile, I would like us to go department by department. Let's start with the goalkeeping department. I think Ronwen Williams selects himself. He's the captain, fantastic leader. We saw he played a big game away from home when we played Ethiopia. He played a big game when we played here at home. He gave us a captain's performance.
Yeah.
And you're looking at what he's doing locally in our football. 9 games that he has played in all competition, 6 goals that they have scored against him, but he's got 5 clean sheets. 5 clean sheets. Only Onyango has more clean sheets than him. You go to the number 2 goalkeeper that the coach has chosen. It's Motua. 13 games that he has played, 11 against. He also has 5 clean sheets. Mm. So those two keepers, they select themselves as 1 and 2. But the difficulty that the coach has is a lot of our PSL teams don't have South African goalkeepers playing, which makes it very difficult. Go to Sundowns. It's not a South African goalkeeper. Go to Kaizer Chiefs. It's not a South African goalkeeper. Orlando Pirates, only now Mpochani is playing. You have to go to Waroka to find Oscar Nmasuluke, who's playing at home. The third choice goalkeeper, therefore, is Bruce Vuma. When last did Bruce Vuma play for his club? On the 12th of September is the last time Bruce Vuma played for Kaizer Chiefs. Mm-hmm. The last time he was on the bench was on the 18th of September. So the other thing that I heard, because I had the privilege and the honor of being here when the coach was selecting the team for the first time until now, he said he has got his number 1, he has got his number 2. He does not want to break that competition and that camaraderie between the goalkeepers. And I guess that's why you still see Bruce Vuma there.
And that's the question, Coach, because it's Bruce Vuma who isn't making the bench at the moment at Kaizer Chiefs. You had Oscarine as well in, you know, your preliminary squad. The choice between the two led you back to Bruce Vuma.
Yeah, because Bruce was already the two first times with us, and I don't have complaints about him. He's working good on training, he's a young keeper. For me, he's a quality keeper. But okay, his coach decides differently, and as what you said, 2 weeks ago, I checked how many South African keepers were playing. There were 3. In all the clubs, 3 South African players, keepers who are playing.
Mm.
So start and look for keepers.
Yeah.
So therefore, my confidence stays in Bruce, even when he don't play. But again, I know if it goes on like this, one moment I have to change. Because yes, maybe tomorrow I need him. And then I have to put a keeper who is not ready to play that game. So, but for the moment, my confidence is with Bruce, and he will be there for these games, and we will see in the next months, because then it will be only March before we have other games, and we will see then what happens with him.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll be tracking.
And also, the issue of the goalkeepers is not something new. Eh? It's been there if you go for the past few seasons, and it's going to continue affecting the national team. And now it's not just in the top division only. You go to JDR. JDR has got also a foreign goalkeeper, Sangare, who's a third choice in the Cote d'Ivoire national team. There's also a Benin goalkeeper also playing in the first division. There's Mendez, who's the first choice goalkeeper at Black Leopards. You also have a Ugandan goalkeeper who's the number one at Kellys. So it's something. And also you find that at some clubs in the top division, first choice goalkeeper is a foreign goalkeeper. Second choice goalkeeper is a foreign goalkeeper. So if we go to what Egypt did, and even when they tried to change it, then they was like, no, we have to go back. No foreign goalkeeper in the Egyptian Premier League. I'm not saying let's go that route, but maybe let's say one foreign goalkeeper per club.
Right, let's take a look now at the defenders as we've exhausted the goalkeepers. Ronwen Williams keeping his place there as South Africa's number one. And of course, Willie Mutwa as the number two there. Bruce Wuma coming in third as you see it in front of you. Let's move now to defenders. I look at these defenders and I see a couple of changes there. One actually that sticks out. Thibang Pete then makes his way in. And Jabulani Ngcobo of Kaizer Chiefs makes his way into those defenders. Coach, before we do get into that, you're going to perhaps give us a little bit more about your defenders.
I think most of them were there in the previous game. But again, Thibang Pete was not with us the last game because after the game against Ghana, he had COVID. Mm. Also Sitole. Yeah. So, and therefore I didn't select them for Ethiopia, because they were 2 weeks out, I think, and then the tempo of the game, and they have been sick. So that's the reason they were not there for the game against Ethiopia. And now he's again there, Pete, because I think he's a good defender. And I saw the games he played also with Belenenses.
Yeah.
So, and that's my choice.
We're going to go to Promozio. Give us a little bit of stats on Thibang Pete, who plays his football in Portugal. And of course, a little bit earlier in his career, played, you know, for Stars of Africa and Milano here in South Africa. Jabulani Ngcobo makes his entrance there, coach, under your defenders.
I'm sorry?
Jabulani Ngcobo is...
Yeah. Okay, but Jabulo don't play as a defender in his team. Mm. And we did it also against Ethiopia. And I will not blame him, certainly not. But he's not really a midfielder. Mm. He's a very good defender.
Yeah. Mm.
And that's why I took him as a defender. I saw it in the game against Ethiopia. I took him to replace Mvala,
yeah,
because he played in his team. And I said, okay, they will not change so much for this guy. But he wasn't comfortable on the field. You saw it. He's a very good defender. So for me, it's a defender.
When you're looking at that department, not much has changed. Terence Mashiko is still there. You look at Mobi, has been a great servant for the coach, the country. And that's one player that we were questioning before as a country, but he has shown his quality at Skukune. The two centre-backs are starting to select themselves in Rashin Durek and also Kulu. Those are the two centre-backs. The experience of Thanti is also very important for the young Mashiko, because you will be able to guide him. On the other side, at right-back, is vice versa, because the youngster, Blom, is the one that is understanding from Umobi. What I love is what the coach has done to bring in Thibang Pete. 9 appearances in all competitions in mm-hmm. Portugal this season. You're looking at a player that played 29 games in all competitions last season. He's not just there to add numbers. You look at his physicality, you look at his height, you look at the versatility of the player. He can play as a centre-back. He can also play as a defensive midfielder. A man that already has a cap for Bafana Bafana, made his debut against Namibia in a friendly game. So he has been waiting for this opportunity. Is he going to bring so much competition that is going to give the coach a headache to think about Deruk and Kulu? They need competition, and when you have got high competition in the team, it means that the standard of everyone in the team will lift. And that's what I'm excited about, to see a person that is playing out in Portugal regularly,
yeah,
being selected for Bafana Bafana. Is he going to push for that position that is left by Mvala in midfield, or is the coach going to look for him to compete in that centre-back position? That is the big question, but it widens the pool for the coach in terms of who is he going to select against Zimbabwe and also Ghana.
It does mean, though, with Peter coming in, coach, that Fleurs doesn't make your team.
Yeah, okay. This is a choice.
Yeah.
No, I don't have to tell D for this or for that, yeah, or for... But, yeah, Peter is there now, and this is the choice. What do I do? And as he said, Peter is playing in Belenenses.
Yeah.
It's not a high top competition, but he's playing. And this is something I said when I came here also. Everybody came to me, hey coach, the foreign players, the previous coach didn't select the foreign players or not enough. And then I said, yes, foreign players, they are abroad, mm-hmm, but they don't play.
Yeah.
So why don't you have to select them? Because they are there? No, they have to play. And with Pete and with Sitole, you have two players, Xulu also, they play in their team. Mm. And they can maybe put something extra on the team.
Well, let's take a look at that midfield that you mentioned that does have Sitole in it, as we bring up the graphic now so you're able to follow with us. The midfield team that has been selected, of course, there includes Sphephelo Sithole. Many in South Africa might not know him, hasn't played top flight football in South Africa, of course. The difference of 22 years old, he has played 8 games this season. Phumutso, you do know the stats on him, and I'll get back to you on that in just a bit. Coach, you saw Sphephelo Sithole. What did you like about him?
Sithole?
Yeah.
First of all, maybe this is not, but he's tall. No, but in that position, it's important. And when you see Mvala is tall. I need someone there in position who is tall, not someone like Mokoena, for example. Even if Mokoena is strong with the head, he's a good header, but Sithole is tall.
So he's a lanky oak, yeah.
For me, on that position, first of all, this is something, but also his qualities. So when I see him playing, he recuperates many balls in the midfield of Belenenses, sometimes a bit little too, because he has many yellow cards, or regularly yellow cards, so he has to be a little bit calmer sometimes. But I like more that than I have to push up someone and say, hey, come on. So he has the good mentality, and we will see the next weeks or the next days what we are going to do with him.
In fact, I'm happy to see Sithole, coach, because I spoke to him before the Olympics, and he was so looking forward to go to the Olympics. Unfortunately, his team closed that opportunity for him, and a product of the KZN Academy, which has produced very good players, and also you had selected him with Pete for the first your first camp, and unfortunately due to COVID times at those times, and I'm happy to also see that now everything has been relaxed in foreign leagues, so things can go back to normal, and it's good to have him back in the team.
Joined Belenenses in the season 17-18, of course, after having started in the under-19 team at Sporting. It is a man from the KZN Academy, 22 years old. Now we move on, coach, to one of the most anticipated call-ups in a long time, because with his performances recently achieved, there was a big question mark on whether he'd be called up or not. But from the conversations we've had, you've been following him, Keegan Donnie.
Yeah, and for me it's not a midfield. For me it's a forward. I see him playing now with his team, and he played very good. When I came here, I selected him for Uganda. But then his wife gave birth on his first child, and he asked not to be selected, and I couldn't understand it. But what I saw from the previous games, he was midfield. So now I see him playing in his team, and I think that his coach did a very good work, because he's in good shape. And I read also from his coach that he had to work very hard to come on that shape. So he was a little bit lost, I think, the last months. But what I did now is he's quick, he has a good center, he scores, he gives decisive passes. So yeah, he's someone you have to select. If I shouldn't do it, I should make an error, I should make a mistake. So he's in good shape, and I'm very happy with him that he can come to us. But for me, it's a winger and not a midfielder.
Keegan Dolly there, coach, saying selected himself. Phumutso, you've got the numbers, particularly on the big question mark on Sphephelo Sithole.
Yeah, I think my answer will start with, I'll carry on from what the coach has said. Keegan Dolly, 9 appearances, 3 goals, 4 assists for Kaizer Chiefs. Those numbers don't lie. You play 9 games, and you are involved in 7 goals that are being scored by a club. That's fantastic. Let's not forget that we are graduating a man here who in 2016 was the captain of the Olympics team, Keegan Dolly. He's played his football in France. He has won the Champions League with Mamelodi Sundowns. A man that is very comfortable on the ball, has got the game-changing pass, which is the penetrative pass, hardly plays ball sideways, mentality very good, 1v1 situations can go past players, and this is a man that can really lift this Bafana team. Coach tried in the previous selection to go for a left-sided player. He had selected Vincent Pule,
yeah.
Unfortunately, Vincent Pule got injured during the warm-up.
Yeah.
So we're left a little bit thin on the left-hand side.
Yeah.
We had to go with Kutumela, who's a right-footed player, playing on the left-hand side. Now you've got a man that has played overseas. You have a man that has won the Champions League. You've got a man that has been to the Olympics and captained our under-23s at the national team. What a way to welcome Keegan Dolly. That was one of the players that I was looking forward to, coach, that you're going to include in your team. And as always, the coach didn't disappoint me. He included the men.
Assistant coach Wafana sitting right next to us here. But before we do, because I want to take a very quick ad break and come back on the other side, and we can do the strikers and the permutations for the next 2 games. Sphephelo Sithole.
Oh, yeah, yes. In the previous game, when we played away from home, I thought Mvala brought a lot of stability into that midfield for us. A ball winner helps us during defending set play and offensive set play. That's what Mvala brings. A lot of physicality, breaks play, does not have that ability to then start play. But in that position, the important thing is for you to be able to block the passing lanes and be able to protect the back four. Mvala did that very well. Now, you only see the importance of Mvala when he's not available, when we play at home against Ethiopia. We didn't have the balance in that midfield, with all respect to Ngobo, who played in that position. Now, you need a player that is in that mold. He's not just nicknamed Yaya for nothing. What is different between Usithole and also Mvala? The difference is Sithole has the ability to drive the team forward. He's able to carry the ball from a defensive zone and then carry the ball into the offensive third. And that's one quality that he brings. 10 appearances for his team out in Portugal. That's amazing, Andile. You're looking at last season, 29 appearances in all competition. Come back to the question again. Coach is selecting an overseas player that is playing, an overseas player that is 22. An overseas player that is 1.91 in terms of height. He brings the physicality. I can't wait to see him wearing that Bafana jersey.
And an overseas player who also had offers in good leagues. Mm. He had offers in the Bundesliga. He had offers in French Ligue 1, in Spain as well. Mm. And him coming to the national team setup and playing in the World Cup qualifiers could also reignite that foreign interest that he had in those big leagues. Mm. Because this is the big stage. Where he's used to playing, he's playing in a league where there's Sporting Lisbon, there's Benfica, there's also Porto. These are teams that are playing in the Europa League, they are playing in the UEFA Champions League as well.
Hashtag Asibuyele Mufa, forward we go, the SABC standing behind Safa, and of course Bafana Bafana with our coach Hugo Bruce. We're going to take a very quick air break, but coach, before we do, these are great things being said about Bete as well as Sithole. But when you look at their team, Belenenses, in the league and how poorly they're playing, these are two defensive players that play in those teams, but they haven't won a game. They've won one game in the last 12 matches in the league. Does that worry you a little bit?
No. No. Because as you said, those are only two players. There are nine others. So and it's not because you lose eight times that it's Sithole and Pete who are responsible for that. I just look at the performances. I don't look if they win, if they lose. That's not interesting for me. I want to see how they are playing. And this was, for me, this was the reason to call them and to select them. Not because they didn't win nine games or whatever.
Yeah.
This is when you see a game as a coach, Bafana Bafana, and also my two assistants, we just look at the performance of the player. We don't look at, is the team playing good? Is defense good? Pete plays in defense, okay. Is he playing good? And that's important. And therefore, I think they have to be with us now for those two important games.
Important indeed, the two games, 11th and 14th of November. The SABC saying, as we